Hey, this is Captain Trips. I'm going to be going over some basics and procedures for Hyena Squad for this upcoming op. For people that don't know me, I'm a former Marine infantryman. I did a lot of training in buildings very similar to the ones in this AO. So I'm just going to be making a quick rundown of our operating procedures. Alright, so basics. We don't ever want to stack up. Stacking is bad. It's just the worst. Don't do it if you are stacked up, because there are certain times you're going to want to stack up. Just know that if you're stacked up for more than 2 seconds, it's wrong, and you want to fix the situation by unstacking. Alright. So when we're clearing rooms, we're going to be using three simple calls. Either when you go in, if there's an enemy in there, you're going to call for support. So just say support, 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 loud, clearly, three times. If you go in and there's enemies in there, but they're entrenched in and you don't want to have the rest of the squad come rushing into that room because they'll just be mowed down, just yell frag, 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 and we'll toss a grenade in there, clear it out. If you go down, we'll medic you, all that. Third call is clear. That's pretty self-explanatory. It's cleared out. That's not necessarily going to be like cleared and search for intel. That's just no enemy combatants in there. And then lastly, don't be afraid to be just like, hey, can I get two more people in here? It's a just awkward room. You need two more people. Maybe there's a piece of furniture you gotta like open up and make sure there's not a guy hiding in a closet or some shit like that. You don't really need to explain yourself when you just call for two. Just call for two people. Two people come in, be like, hey, we're gonna open this closet. If anyone's hiding in there, we're going to gun them the fuck down. Alright. That being said, when we're clearing rooms, the point man, the first person going in the room, is always right. It doesn't matter if you have a slightly better idea of how to like clear the room, something like that. Just, we want to be quick, we want to be done, we don't need to debate. Oh, well, I think it'd be better if we go to left first. Like, doesn't fucking matter. Point man's always right, just go with it. Unless it's something incredibly, incredibly terrible. In which case, defer to your team leader. Or squad leader, excuse me. Point man is always right, especially if it is a point woman, because we do have quite a few female players on our squad. Formation. This is just me, but I've always been taught that formations, you're attacking to the front, and you're always calling things out to the formation's right, to the formation's left, and to the formation's rear. That's because if I call out, hey, there's a guy on my right, you don't have to worry about, like, well, which way is he facing? Which way is his right? It's just pretty evident if we're going clearing forward, and I'm like, someone's to our right, everyone knows, well, our formation's pointing this way, so the right is that way. When we're clearing this, we're really outgunned here. They have a whole extra platoon on us, so we're going to want to be clearing with speed and intensity. When we have a bunch of people dedicated to clearing one room, that's a huge force multiplier for them, because we have a whole squad in one room not doing anything. We want to get these buildings cleared out as quickly as possible so we can do things like secure the building, search for objectives, things like that. Alright, let's keep moving. Alright, so the first building type that we're going to be dealing with is these chow hall squad bays. This isn't to scale. These rooms are huge, and then they have just kind of awkward, weird rooms all around them. So basically, we're going to be breaching into wherever, whichever point, and we're going to want to form a line right across, and we're going to be treating this as like a danger open field, because these are big rooms. When I say this isn't to scale, I mean like we're going to have guys. Our whole squad's going to be lined up with, like, 6-foot dispersion, and we're going to still have room on our left and our right. So we're going to be all lined up, guns pointing forward. We're going to send one or two guys, depending, into these little side rooms to go clear them out. These rooms do not have furniture. These aren't furnished rooms. It doesn't look like there's any kind of tables, chairs, anything like that left over. Some of them might, but under the assumption that these are all empty buildings cleared out, it doesn't take a lot to clear a room. And ideally, we want to have two people. But if we don't, and we have to clear with one person, I think it's very capable that we can. And just remember our three calls. If you go into a room, there's someone there. You think, hey, we can take them. Call for support. Get like three or four more guys in that room. Shoot them. If you go in that room, like, nope, this guy is... He found the one piece of cover. He's in a nook and cranny. He's got a full line of sight on the door. He's going to kill all of us if we go running in. Just call for that frag where we're just going to toss grenades into the room. When you have rooms like this where you charge in and it's clear, but then there's another doorway like leading out this way, we don't know that there's no wall here. We don't know that you're going to be coming out of this way. So you want to make sure you call, hey, one friendly coming out. So we get this cleared. And this isn't like an actual written floor plan. This is just kind of an example room, but we get our first room cleared. That becomes our casualty collection point. We either stick our squad leader or our medic in there. We search that room thoroughly for intel while they're just kind of chilling, waiting, being rear security. Our squad starts advancing up. As we get here, we send people into this room, clear it out. Okay, it's been cleared. We keep moving this line forward. We get people into this room. This is one of those things where, like, hey, this is a really awkward room. There's like a dividing wall or something. And so it's like two long hallways. I need two more guys. You get, you know, two guys here, move forward. Squad keeps moving up, sends guys to clear rooms, move up this way. Once the whole area is clear, we're going to break off. We'll set security, break off, search thoroughly for intel. Also, a lot of these are chow halls. Some of them are squad-based, some of them are chow halls. These are all really big buildings. If it is a chow hall and it has like some kind of crazy walk-in freezer, we want to clear that, but make sure someone's outside that walk-in freezer so you don't get locked in. Just kind of a safety thing. Don't be like the Velociraptor in Jurassic Park. Anyway. All right, so that's the chow hall, large squad bay. Once again, we come in. We line up, we break off one or two guys to clear these side rooms, and as we slowly advance the line forward, we're treating it as a open field danger area, not a room, because these are such large rooms with no kind of cover. We just want to get as many guns as we can pointed straight down, you know, pointed at these doorways where guys might pop out of, and then just suppress the hell out of them, because there's not going to be cover. All we're going to have is suppression. If someone's in the using that doorway to shoot at us. All right. So this is the other type of building I saw in here. These are the kind of modified. I think they were used for Katrina victims as like modified housing. Basically, they're one long hallway, and then they're like cheap drywall walls divided up. It's going to be one long hallway. This is when we stack up. This is probably the only time we want to be in stacks. So keep in mind for these long hallways, the let's say we're going in here. We got rooms on our right. We got nothing on our left. They might be windows. They're not going to be able to shoot through us at windows, but they're going to get a good view of what we're doing. We're going to have cover but not concealment, which is weird. There might be broken windows where we suddenly come to a point where they can start shooting in. It also might just be entirely open. It might be a railing, something like that. So depending on what kind of situation, keep that stuff in mind. All right, so for these long hallways, we want to have two guys on the long hallway side. One guy is going to be pointed forward. The other guy is going to be pieing off the room in front of us, and then we're going to have our stack. Our stack is going to send two guys in. They're going to clear this room. We're going to move the stack forward. These guys on the side are going to keep moving up in line with the stack. And we're going to clear this room. After this room has been clear, these two guys are going to start searching for intel. All right. So then we're going to keep moving it forward. Now let's say this room has an enemy combatant and we call for support. These two guys are going to be in this room, and the thing about these rooms, what I've seen from urban exploration videos that I've been watching, is they're not nice solid walls. They got all these like chunks and divots knocked out. So we have small little, we can fit half our torso through, we can fit, you know, head, shoulders, we got little knocked out pieces of drywall that we can kind of move and shoot through if we need to. We have long holes. These are the ideal thing where you're sitting, you just cleared a room, there's this long hole, the next two guys moved and cleared the next room, they called for support. You can just Kool-Aid man through this giant hole in the wall and get into the next room and help support. We're also going to have things like, it looks like it's a nice big hole, but there's going to be some kind of, like, there's going to be 2x4s, maybe there's going to be wires running across this way, so you're going to have to carefully get through. Once again, you can go support through these holes, just be careful because when you're in gear, you're 6 to 8 inches bigger than you are out of gear, so it's really easy to get hung up on these things. You don't want to get stuck trying to charge into a room, clothesline yourself or something like that. And then these doorways, when we're walking past, we need to be moving quick because these doorways, we're going to have doorways, but there's going to be these little tiny, you know, holes punched in the wall. There's going to be cracks in the wall, things like that where people in the room, if we're not sending two guys in to clear right away, they can shoot out at us. They can shoot out through these little pie holes and whatnot. And then as far as stack procedures, if I think the most dangerous course of action is we have our whole stack, we're ready to go in a room, and someone just sticks their fist through holding some kind of grenade and drops a grenade into the hallway that our entire stack is in, something like that happens, it's just going to be go. Everyone just goes forward into the next room, clears it out. Even if this doorway is closer, you don't want to try and backtrack, because if you try and backtrack and the guy in front of you tries to go forward, you're going to get locked together and both of you are going to get blown up. Also, same thing with if this is a big open area and enemy combatants start firing down at us, it's just once again, okay, let's go. Everyone gets into the next room. All right. And then once again, make sure we're doing good sweeps for intel, because intel is probably going to be small key cards or keys. To unlock areas and things of that nature. All right, another little point for if something like this happens where there's a hole and it leads into another room, we're just going to push through. We're going to clear that next room. We're going to see what's going on over there, but then we're going to fall back, which is kind of counterintuitive. I know you're not supposed to do that, but we're very outnumbered here, so we're not going to have... we're probably not going to have the numbers where we can start clearing in multiple directions at once. We're just going to fall back, hold this as we clear the rest of the building out. Alright, so that's the ruined long hall. Once again, that's the only time we stack. People in the stack are ready to support, frag, or move up, depending on those three calls. Alright. And then the other big terrain feature is going to be these stairwells. The stairwells, sometimes they're going to be in the center of the building. Sometimes they're going to be at the ends of the buildings. Sometimes they're going to be all both. There's going to be one on each side. If it's an open air stairwell, which is usually the sides of the buildings, make sure your guns are up. We want to keep really good 360 degree coverage. Alright, and then we're moving up the stairs. The first two guys, they need to hit their corners. Because if there's a guy hiding here, we need to get him cleared out. That's much more important than guys in the front of the stairs. Because we can all blob up these stairs and take out guys in front of the stairs. Much easier than if we have people, you know, camped out right on these corners ready to shoot us as we come up. Clearing stairs is... it's kind of hard, but it's kind of easy. If we can clear from top down, that's much preferred because it's much easier to clear top down than it is to clear up. But obviously, we don't actually have actual helicopter support or anything like that, so we're not going to be landing on rooftops. But if we can get to the top of a building, clear the third floor, and then work our way down, that's preferred. But anyway, so if we're going upstairs, first two guys... their guns are going up straight forward. Everyone else, just guns straight up, looking for little overhead ledges where people are shooting down at us. We don't necessarily want to be stacked up for clearing stairwells. We just kind of want to blob forward and use numbers Not obviously so much that we're tripping over each other, but just so we can bring 4 to 8 guns to the fight if we need to. And then make sure we don't lose rear security, because we don't want everyone going up the stairwell looking this way, and then one guy comes out and just schwacks us all. And then if we are doing exterior stairwells, make sure we're picking the best exterior stairwell. If there's a building where we could be taking enemy fire from, it's better just to walk around the building and use the stairwell that we're not going to be taking enemy fire from. All right, so I think that's the basics. If anyone has any questions, shoot me a comment on YouTube or on Facebook, and we'll go over it. We can also go over a lot of this stuff on the trip up. If you find this video and you're not in Hyena Squad and you like any of these things, do it. I am fairly sure that we're going to have this ruined long haul and we're going to have these Chow Hall squad bays, so talk to your squad about how you want to be clearing this stuff. All right, thanks for your time. Bye.